What happens here is you move this lever, you go up and down, and left and right, and use this lever to go in and out. And that's, those are the two controls you have for cutting operations. But the other part of it is that there are five cutting stations. There's this pentagonal turret here. You sort of unlock things by shifting a lever here, and the belt pops up from here onto this one, and then you turn the turret to the next station, and then you move the other lever, and it pops back, and the belt pops back down onto the next pulley. But what happens here is that this stylus, in the cutting operation, this stylus follows the sheet metal pattern here. And then this cutter here, which is the same diameter as the stylus, repeats that in the wood, repeats the motion in the wood. And it's very straightforward, and such things are still used in various ways. These horns here are pipes. They blow air in there, clean this one out. This one is not so important to have wood chips out of, but if you have wood chips in here, it'll change the shape of the pattern, essentially, and it won't work, so you have to have something to blow that out. So this thing is the same, about the same time as that one, made about the same time as that one. And, you know, we're talking, again, very sophisticated stuff here. Mm-hmm. Interestingly enough, at the back, there is a milling machine that uses exactly the same principle, except it doesn't have a turret. It has just two side-by-side operations, and instead of moving two levers, you have two cranks, because it's cutting metal, and profiling metal, and so because the cutting forces are so much higher in metal. You can't use these levers in this way.
Is this a Blanchard innovation?
I don't know how much he had to do with it, but you know, certainly the Blanchard lathe idea inspired that. Yes, definitely.
What is it actually cutting there? I mean, what part of the...
Okay, so this is for a, what's called a side hammer percussion rifle. So okay. You have a lock plate that goes there with the mechanism. It's set into the side of the rifle.
So that's all that machine did.
Yeah, but it's a fairly elaborate recess. And trying to carve that out by hand is quite time-consuming, especially if you want it to fit well.
Special purpose machine.
So.